No product has played an outsized role in shaping the global economy and balancing military power as semiconductors. Still, for many years, this $556 billion industry attracted scant attention from governments in Washington, Tokyo, and many other capitals in the developed world. Recently, chips are now a battleground in the rivalry between the United States and China. Big companies and other countries will suffer from the fight. So, how did this happen? What does this mean for ASML? Let's find out. Welcome back to ASML Monopoly. In this video today, we will be looking at how ASML is becoming a casualty of the China-US tech war. So clearly, you do not want to miss out on this. So, let's begin. While ASML's global monopoly is not widely recognized, the truth always finds its way into financial markets. Also, ASML's stock price skyrocketed from $158 per share in 2018 to almost $849 per share in 2021 at the height of the worldwide semiconductor supply chain squeeze. For example, Amazon's stock price was $176 each share during the same period. ASML's stock price fell to about $470 in September 2022, reflecting more general market conditions. Analysts at Global Data characterize ASML as the semiconductor industry's Atlas company. It is the company bearing the heaviest burden for the whole semiconductor in the industry's supply chain. Moreover, ASML's EUV lithography machines are now the only way the world's three big chip makers, Taiwan's TSMC, US company Intel, along with South Korea's Samsung, can print leading-edge chips. These are the most advanced 5-nanometer and 3-nanometer chips. ASML's monopoly in manufacturing EUV machines and the fact that these lithography machines are the most expensive step in making advanced chips place the company in a unique position. China's semiconductor industry has lagged behind the US in patents and lagged South Korea and Taiwan in fabrication. Still, it hopes to leapfrog its competition by adopting revolutionary new chip design technologies. The new and advanced chips used in 5G smartphones and some workstations squeeze billions of transistors and onto a fingernail-sized chip by shrinking the dimensions of the transistor itself to around 3 to 5 nanometers. Most of the chips have gate widths of 28 nanometers and higher. Etching tiny circuits on silicone is really hard. Only the Dutch manufacturer ASML makes lithography machines that use the short wavelengths at the end of the ultraviolet spectrum to shorten the transistors to such small dimensions. Also, the fabrication plants are very costly, costing up to almost $20 billion each. In the year 2020, the US forced the Dutch government to ban exports of ASML's most sophisticated lithography machines to China. ASML uses American-based intellectual property, giving Washington leverage. However, ASML continued to sell its previous generation of lithography equipment, which etches 14-nanometer transistors using deep ultraviolet light. China bought 81 of these machines in 2021 alone. China's largest fabricator, the Semiconductor Manufacturing International Corporation, or the SMIC, now produces 14-nanometer chips. With around 5% of the world's fabrication market, SMIC lags behind its Taiwanese and Korean competitors, but is expanding rapidly. As reported in Asia Times just last month, Washington asked the Dutch government to stop ASML from selling the previous DUV machines to China. The semiconductor industry executives told the reports that the Dutch would not increase to the American demand. Then, ASML's China sales exceeded $2 billion in 2021, which included the 81 DUV lithography machines. At the same time, chip designers have learned how to build three-dimensional chips using what the industry calls advanced packaging. In the process, that has been used in chip making for many years, and layers of chips with bigger transistors stacked on top of each other can even produce configuration speeds equal to one-dimensional configuration of the tiniest chips. Moreover, Intel has bet the company's future on recent advancements in advancing packaging. Taiwan semiconductor manufacturing company, the industry leader, has likewise invested heavily in newer process forms. Samsung has also established a task for advanced packaging, hoping to leapfrog Intel and TSMC, which now account for 32% and 27% of investment in the process. On the other hand, one of the star performers in China's stock market this year is semiconductor equipment maker Shanghai Microfabrication, with a 25% year-to-date gain, while industry leader ASML fell by 45%. Shanghai Micro's income rose to 573 million yuan, about 85.2 million in 2021, from 133 million in the year 2020, as the upstart equipment maker benefited from restrictions on sales of advanced semiconductor equipment to China. Also, the global chip shortage has turned into a glut, with widespread cancellation of orders because most of the main economies are in or close to recession. The semiconductor stocks are among the worst performers year-to-date, except in China, where geopolitics has given the sector a tailwind. In the U.S., the Biden administration is considering new measures to prevent China from buying chip-making equipment. This also seems to be a response to Chinese advances in chip-making methods, including advanced packaging. Washington is trying to close the barn door after the horse is bolted. China's chip-making equipment companies and the primary beneficiaries of the tech war will eventually fill the gap. Shanghai Microelectrics, who is China's leading producer of lithography equipment that can meet the country's needs in older gen chips of 90 nanometers and above, and allegedly has shipped its first 28 nanometer machines. China's share of the world's semiconductor manufacturing capacity was 11% in 2010 and is forecast to rise to 24% by 2030. According to an OECD study, China's $170 billion National Integrated Circuit Fund accounted for almost 86% of all government grants, the below-market equity to chipmakers between 2014 and 2018. At the same time, the U.S. Congress hasn't been able to pass a $52 billion package to subsidize semiconductor production in the U.S. In response to their legislative delay, Intel called off a July 22nd groundbreaking ceremony for a chip fabrication plant in Ohio. The TSMC has warned that its projected fab in Arizona might not be built, and according to U.S. chip industry sources, Intel is relieved that the Ohio project may be put on ice. Furthermore, the sudden softening of the semiconductor market and the threat of a chip glut following the global shortage of 2020 to 2021 remove the need for additional capacity. Also, Intel has $10 billion a year in free cash flow and can finance its own expansion if it has the customers. The U.S. Commerce Department in early July told the business press of the record that it was considering extending restrictions on semiconductor equipment exports to China to include older technologies that make less advanced chips. The danger of such restrictions and the important advances in homegrown Chinese capabilities have supported the stock prices of domestic Chinese equipment producers, which also benefit from government subsidies. Lithography is a key bottleneck in China's efforts to achieve a high degree of independence in chip manufacturing. Today, ASML is the world's only producer of extreme ultraviolet lithography machines that etch circuits for the most advanced chips with 7 nanometers or fewer gate widths. Only TSMC and Samsung can produce them. The Donald Trump administration banned exports of these chips, shutting down the 5G handset business of Huawei and ZTE, and also bribed the Dutch government to ban sales of EUV machines to China. SMIC has only 5% of the world market share. However, its revenue has doubled over the past 18 months. It can produce 14 nanometer chips. Well, except for smartphones and a few specialist applications, 14 nanometers and above chips make up 95% of world chip demand. Even though Huawei's 5G handset business collapsed without access to 7 nanometer and below chips, China had no issue building out its 5G station network with extensive chips. However, a revolution is underway in chip design, or perhaps several revolutions. All the new technologies, including new forms of advanced packaging, will provide an alternative path to ever smaller gateway, width, and possibly lower costs. What are your thoughts on this? Let us know in the comments section down below. If you enjoyed today's video and found it interesting, then be sure to leave us a thumbs up. And do not forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to be kept up to date with the most exciting content as soon as it's uploaded. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon in another video.